98online.com/livewire.
Coming to the main stage, Stella. Scotty.
I'll kill you.
What? I just said that 18 years.
I will kill you.
18 years from now, your little angel will be the prettiest stripper in town.
Yeah, that Q guy is pretty short-winded, isn't he? It's amazing.
Hey, man, first of all, congratulations, pal.
Thank you. Can you hear her?
I can hear her.
Hold on.
Shut up. Shut up. I hate your father.
Hey, that's now my life.
Oh, that is so beautiful.
I'm so
Can I talk to her again, Scott?
Who's in the studio, first of all? I'm confused. I'm hearing voices.
Okay. Joining us in the studio is Jim Meyer.
Hey, that's me.
You know Jim?
Yes. Hi, Jim.
Lowell Melzer.
Congrats. Scott!
Oh, God.
Oh, God.
And, of course, you remember Aaron Redding. Aaron was up before with Blondies.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Hi, Scott.
How are
Congratulations.
You? Congratulations.
Right,
cool. Thank you.
So, listen, let me talk to your daughter again.
Okay, hold on.
All right. Listen, your father's a jackass. He's got a huge nose. He's a crybaby. She is so lovely, Scott.
Yeah, I'm going to put a bottle in her mouth right here.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's perfect, man.
Yeah, be careful.
Tiny. 5 pounds, 15 ounces.
How long was
that? That is a tiny baby.
Yeah, 5'15".
Now, big questions I got to know. I know
Let's
it. I know you do because I know the kind of man you are. How comfortable are you putting the diaper on?
Very comfortable.
How comfortable?
I've changed about 100 already.
Yeah. How comfortable are you cleaning the little baby vagina and butt area? Because that's a very complicated scenario.
You got no problem with it. You got to get
front to back.
Front to back. You got to get all that fecal matter out.
Yeah. And sometimes it gets crusty in there, and you're like, ah. You get off.
You got to get up in there.
Yeah, you do. And you got to eat. Well, you know. Listen, everything else good, though? Like, there was you know what I'm saying. No complications. Mommy was good through everything.
Yeah, no, everything was great. We went in on Friday. She was supposed to be, she was a week late.
Yeah.
She was supposed to be induced.
Well, she's Mexican.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, but
Mexicans
come on.
Are usually early.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. They should have been early, but they stay late.
So as we were driving there, she, like, for an 8 o'clock at night induction, she, like, started to have pains. And she's like, I'm starting to have pains. And I'm like, really? So we get in there, and we're like, well, we think it might just be happening. So they hook her up, and sure enough, it's just, like, it started on its own. So
they didn't induce.
Well, they were, like, starting the process, but every time they would, like, order a test or order something and then come back and check her, they're like, we don't even need that because it's just going on its own. So, she pretty much went on her own.
Now, did she give birth vaginally? Okay.
Now,
let me ask
you.
I saw the whole thing. Yeah, you were right there, right?
I saw the whole
thing. Hey, I got two words for you. You pick which one. Big Mac, catcher's mitt.
I'll go quarter pounder.
Yeah, it's unbelievable, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it was like you're just standing around, you're waiting. He comes in, he checks her, and then all of a sudden he's like, all right, we're going to have you start pushing. And you're like, uh-oh, here it goes.
Yeah.
How long was the whole labor?
Yeah, how long was it?
She probably started at like 8 at night, and she was born at 8:13 a.m.
Oh, 12 hours. 12 hours. Now, were you awake the whole time?
No, well, we got a little bit of sleep. I mean, there's people coming in and out of the room every half hour, so it's tough. But
yeah. Now, is she, and Sandy feels okay now?
Oh, yeah, she's great. Baby's great. Wife's great.
Is she breastfeeding?
No, I'm bottle feeding right now.
Are you doing the little finger thing?
What is the little finger thing?
They might not do it. A lot of times, the babies, especially when they're small, they won't take to, like, either a nipple or a bottle cap or anything. So what you do is you clean your hands real good, and then you stick, like, your pinky in their mouth, and they'll, like, latch onto that, and then they give you, like, a little syringe with the milk in it, and you put that in the corner of their mouth, and you slowly put it in.
We ain't doing all that. We don't need to do that.
Oh, you're lucky. Yeah, I did it with Cassie. It was, like, the most amazing bonding thing I've ever done, like just holding her and feeding her like that was incredible. But isn't feeding her fun? Like just holding her and feeding her?
Yeah, I mean, I got it right now, so.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead, Jim.
I got to say, man, the picture of you holding Stella for the first time is one of my favorite things on the internet right now. Your smile is bigger than your whole head.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not bigger than your nose, but the rest of your head.
It rivals it, though.
It does rival
it makes your nose look regular.
Yeah. Hey.
No, it's amazing, dude. Like you said, she's, you know, it's a game changer. It's weird.
Dude, let me ask you a question. Now, here's the ultimate question.
Yeah.
And I know you adore and love your wife.
Mm-hmm.
But if it came down as of right now, to your wife and your daughter. It's not even...
Shut
your non-breeding ass up. Us breeders are talking. You would set your wife on fire for your daughter, wouldn't you?
Oh, she just spit up. God damn it.
Yep.
Yes, I would.
Yes, you would.
Can't imagine the scenario where that would be necessary.
Listen.
Yeah.
Listen. He's cleaning up.
Everywhere.
Oh, there you...
Damn it.
That's good.
In the hospital, she... Well, first of all, she got stuck in my wife's vagina.
Yeah.
Ooh. Her head was halfway out.
Yeah, mine got
for like
Cassie got stuck
hour.
Right at the starting gate. She couldn't get out of the gate.
You know, it was the weirdest thing I've ever seen. It was just like this little mini head.
Yeah,
like halfway out of a vagina, just like stuck there.
Yeah,
did it remind you of Ghoulies at all?
Did what?
The movie Ghoulies? Did it remind you of that at all?
I will tell
and
you
then,
what. Go ahead, buddy.
He ended up the way we finally got her out is she's like. It was really funny. The doctor said they had never seen it before. Like, Sandy has, like, a little bit of a cold or whatever, so she started coughing.
And it pushed the baby out?
She coughed the baby out. Like, she shot it out.
Shot the baby out.
I swear to God, she was stuck for, like, a half hour, like a little baby head stuck in a vagina, and then she just, like, coughs, and it just goes, poof, and, like, popped right out. It was crazy.
I've coughed so hard I farted, so I know what that's like.
Same exact, right, that's what
I'm like, I've coughed, I peed a little bit. A baby?
Exactly.
Are you kidding me?
Thing.
Is that a possibility?
That's exactly the same thing. You
gotta be bronchitis at that point. And gotta be borderline bronchitis. Hey, Scott, listen, I honest to God, man, yeah, work aside, everything aside, I'm really so proud and happy for you and Sandy. I know what it means, man, and it's the most amazing thing in the world, and just enjoy it and wait on your wife hand and foot right now, because 10 or 11 years from now, that'll all end. just enjoy it now and love the kids.
And in the hospital, she, well, the baby, I got the first, like, projectile poop.
Nice.
It's incredible, isn't it?
I was like in the middle, you know, like how you grab the legs and you lift the legs up and you're like getting ready to wipe.
Did it get on
as
you?
As I like lift the legs up, it's like, no kidding, it went like 4 feet across the room.
Yeah.
Oh
yeah.
My God.
Yeah. And that's when you call the nurse in.
That's like twice her body length. Yes.
It hit, like,
stunning.
It hit the side of his chair. It was moving at it.
Yes.
That'd be like me doing a 15-foot one. You know what I mean?
I'll tell you, the first time I went...
Yeah,
15-footer.
First time I went to change...
That's off almost from three.
First time I went to change Bubby's diaper, my son, you know, you go, you put, just naturally from having a daughter, you put the, you pick their legs up and you put the diaper under them, and then you pull the top part over. Well, boys have to rock it on top. So... I learned very quickly that you put it on the top first, then fold it under. You don't have to worry because you got a daughter. But, yeah, right dead in the forehead, dude.
First time I was changing Jonah in the hospital, he started peeing everywhere.
Yeah.
And I pointed it back at him, and my wife hit me so hard.
Like, yeah, you can't throw it. It's not a dog. You can't rub his nose in it, Jonah.
Well, now I know. It was my first day.
Well, Scott, listen, man, enjoy. How long are you going to be off for, buddy? A week or two?
Yeah, we just got to figure it out, get settled. I mean, we're not getting much sleep now. She's up every, like, 2 hours. So maybe, like, late next week I might pop in for a day or two.
Okay, well, listen, man, enjoy every moment of it. And, I mean, video a lot of it, man. And you it's going to, I mean, you can't even put it in words how you feel right now. I know that because it's the most amazing thing when you first have a child. And mine was a mistake, so I can't even imagine how yours was, you know, being, no, I'm kidding. Listen, just love it, man, because it's the rest of your life right there, buddy.
All right,
man. And little Stella.
Congrats, Scott.
And I gotta Big Papa.
I got to tell you, I know this is going to hurt your feelings.
Yeah.
She looks just like your wife already, dude.
Oh, thank God. Trust me, I don't care.
I mean, you think so too, though, right?
My buddy said that if she gets my boobs and her everything else, we'll be good.
StudyItOnline.com.